in the Isle of Allor. 1806 we set sail from the cold Key of Cork, and we were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Gun City Hall in New York. And we'd an elegant craft she was like four and a half, and how the trade winds go, but she had 23 masts, and she stood several masts, and they called her the Irish Rover. Well, for a sailor it's always a bothersome life, it's so lonesome by night and by day. Oh, that he longs for the shore, and a dirty young whore that will take all his troubles away. All the noise and the rout smells for chill and stout, for him soon is done and over. For the love of a maid, he has never afraid the soul stop from the Irish Rover. Well, there is Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, there was Hogan from County Tyrone, and there was Big McGuff, who was scarce of work, and the chap from Westmead named Malone. And there was the girl of Till, who was drunk as a fool, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man McMahon from the banks of the Van was the skipper of the Irish Rover. Well, there was 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, there were 2 million barrels of coal, and there were 3 million bales of old Nanny's tales, there was 4 million barrels of stone, and there was 5 million hawks, and 6 million dogs, and 7 million Celtics of port. There were 8 million sides of a blind horse's hide, and the whole of the Irish Rover. Well, we had sailed 7 years when the measles broke out, and the ship lost its way in the fog. And then the whole of the crew was reduced down to two, 'twas myself and the captain's old dog. And then our ship struck a rock, and Lord, what a shock, and nearly tumbled over, tumbled nine around, and the poor dog was drowned.
1, 2, 3.
I'm the last of the Irish Rover.